Hi there. In this video, I'm going to show you how the image editor works in eMarketeer and how you can edit or even create an image from scratch in just a few steps. What's cool with this editor is that it also comes with a stock image library where you find tons of different images that you could use to spice up your content. Okay, so here we go. Here I am in the eMarketeer editor. In this example, I'm going to add an image to an email. So I click Add Content Block, Find Image, and I click it to add an image. If we click Choose an image, we could upload or choose an image that we have previously uploaded to eMarketeer, or we could actually open the image editor right away, which is what we're going to do in this example. From here, I'm going to show you how you create an image from scratch using the four features you find in this editor, and you find them in the left-hand side menu. They are background, shapes, graphics, and texts. It's all pretty straightforward. I'm going to show you all of them. But before I start, I want to mention the toolbar that you find on top here. This is where you find shortcuts such as flip the image, crop, or my two favorite buttons when it comes to image editing, duplicate element and undo. Okay, let's start with background. This is the image itself. So from here, you could just add a background color, upload your own photo if you have one, or if you don't have one, you could search the image library to find something suitable quickly, which is what I'll do here. So as you can see, this is what they find on what I search for. When I have an image that I think works, I could add a nice effect to it by applying one of the filters that you see at the bottom of the screen here. If I want to edit this image even further, I go to the right-hand side panel here. Here I can resize, crop, flip, zoom in, or change the placement of the image. Now we want to add some more details to the image. So the next menu item or feature is shapes. And yes, you guessed it. It means that you could add any of these shapes to your image and then customize it with your colors. So I'm going to add a color here. Here I think I'm going to lower the opacity a bit so you could see the background image through the shape. And then I could just drag the corners to make it the size that I want. Something like that, maybe. Now, the next thing I want to do is add a title or a headline to this image. So I go to text, click add text. And now using the right-hand side panel, I could edit the text box. And what's nice is that the editor remembers the color that you used previously. So it's a little bit of a shortcut, but in this case, I'm gonna actually change it to white. And I'm gonna change the font I like as well. Now I want this text to fit into the shape that I built. So I need to resize it a little bit. Something like that, and add my text, of course. And if I'd like, I could use these options here to customize it even further. Now, one other thing I'd like to mention with the text is that the editor also remembers the fonts that you use. So when you open the text menu, your favorite fonts will be saved in the menu there as favorites. Okay, so now I want to add that little extra to my images and details, and that's when we go over to graphics. Now, this looks similar to background, but graphics, they are elements that you could add to your image. So again, you could search the image library, or you could add an icon here somewhere to this image, or I could also upload my own. I prepared a little bit here, so I uploaded our logo so I could add it to my image. Now, when you're happy with your image, we click save and exit, and the image is added to your email or whichever content that you're working on. Now, if you would like to reuse this image, all images that you edit or create in the image editor, you find them when you click choose image and go to the folder called edited images. And there it is. Now, of course, there are a million and one ways you could edit your images in this editor. So I hope you have fun doing so, and don't forget to make use of the stock image library as well.